Welcome back again in Lataliti. I hope you are all well today. In today's video, I will show you how to create 3D button neomorphism style in a different way in Adobe Illustrator. Neomorphism is a UI design trend in 2020 that is widely applied to app design. I know there are some special apps out there to easily create a neomorphic button design like this, especially for UX designers. But if you're curious about how this neomorphism style was created in Adobe Illustrator, then you should watch this video. Without any further ado, let's open in Adobe Illustrator. As usual, create a document with a size of 1920 by 1080 pixels with RGB color mode. The first step in making this neomorphic button is to make the background first. Here I will create a rectangle object using the rectangle tool following the size of the artboard. Then I gave it a soft yellow color that I took from the color palette I had created. By the way, if you look at neomorphism styles on the internet, you will find they only consist of monochrome colors. The colors in neomorphism only play on brightness. So for the color palette that I made in this Adobe Illustrator tutorial, it only consists of 4 monochrome colors. You can get the color code in the description. Once this background is done, I'm going to lock it first so we don't have to accidentally select it while creating the button, so we can focus on the next step. Next, we are going to create the first neomorphic button. To create this neomorphism style button, we need some circles. Create a circle using the ellipse tool on the toolbar. Once the ellipse tool is selected, click anywhere in the artboard area. Give the size 230 by 230 pixels. To make it easier for us to work, I will place it in the middle of the artboard using the align tool horizontally and vertically. After the position is in the middle, then we will give it a gradient color. Open the gradient panel in the window menu. In this gradient panel, click on this gradient annotator, and it will automatically give us the default black and white gradient color. Click on this white color stop to change its color, and activate the color picker below it, then select a color sample number 2 in the color palette. Click on the other color stop and pick the third color in the palette. After these two color stops are colored, just change the angle to 45 degrees. And for the first circle, we've finished creating it. Now we will create the next circle, but we don't need to create it from scratch, just copy the circle we just created. Go to the edit menu. Copy. Go back to the edit menu. And paste in back. After pasting, change the size to 255 by 255 pixels. Reopen the gradient panel, and click reverse gradient. This will change the position of the color stop in the opposite direction. And click the color stop with this lighter yellow color to change the color. Reactivate the color picker and pick color number 1 in the color palette. Next, copy this larger circle to create another circle. Go to the edit menu. Copy. Back again to the edit menu. Paste in back. Resize it to 400 by 400 pixels. For this circle, we just need to give it a flat color. Activate the color picker on the toolbar. And pick color number 2 on the color palette. Copy this last circle and do the same as the previous one. Copy. And paste in back. Resize it to 600 by 600 pixels. But for this circle, we don't need to change the color. Now we just have to put them together to resemble a three-dimensional object and be more realistic. To blend all these circles, we use the blend tool. Select the blend tool on the toolbar. And start clicking one by one these circles from the smallest first to the larger circle. After everything is clicked, just go to the object menu. Blends. And click blend options. In this blend options panel, change the spacing from normal to specified distance. Then give it a lower value. The lower the value you give, the smoother the transition will be. Finally, just click OK. And here it is. We have finished the button with the neomorphism style. Next, we just add a style to it. Use the rectangle tool and create a small rectangle. Use the direct selection tool to make it round in each corner. Finally, give the third color in the color palette. And here we are. We have successfully created a neomorphism style button by using the blend tool in Adobe Illustrator. Next, I will create a second neomorphism style button with the same technique. Although using the same technique, the result of this neomorphism style button looks different from the previous button that we have created. Everything is the same step by step, we just play with the gradient colors and add some more circles to get a different result. But first, I'm going to move this button so we can focus on creating the next button. We start by creating a circle with a size of 230 by 230 pixels. We use the same size as the base circle on the previous button. Use the eyedropper tool and sample the color from the small circle on the previous button. Remember, must be the smallest circle. Once you've got the gradient color, open the gradient panel and we'll modify it to get a completely different effect. Click the color stop on the left, which has a lighter color. Activate the color picker and choose color number 1 in the color palette, which is the lightest color. Just ignore the other color stop, we don't need to change it. And change the gradient angle to minus 135 degrees, opposite the gradient color in the previous button. Copy this circle to make the second circle. Then paste in back. Resize it to 240 by 240 pixels. On the gradient panel, replace the color stop on the left with the second color in the color palette. And the other one replaces with the fourth color. Copy this circle again, and paste it in back, changing its size to 270 by 270 pixels. Open the gradient panel, and change the color stop color on the left with a lighter color. And the other color stop with the third color in the color palette. Copy the third circle again and paste it in back. Resize it to 400 by 400 pixels. Use the eyedropper tool on the toolbar to sample the second color in the color palette. Duplicate this circle again with a size of 600 by 600 pixels. The final step is blending them using the blend tool. By the way, you can find lots of tutorials about blend tool in this channel. All you have to do is click on the cards above to find them. Do the same with the previous button. Open the blending options panel, and change it to the specified distance with the lowest number. The rest, we can add more accents for this button. What do you think about this neomorphism style button made in Adobe Illustrator? Very easy to create, isn't it? You may think that I made it more difficult by creating this neomorphism style buttons in Adobe Illustrator, but we can learn something new and new techniques by creating this neomorphism style with vector styles in Adobe Illustrator. That's all for today's tutorial. Next I will show you how to create neomorphism style buttons in other ways in Adobe Illustrator, of course in an easier way than I have shown in this video. Don't hesitate to be a part of this channel by pressing the subscribe button and notification bell, because I will make more tutorials about Adobe Illustrator in the future. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments, and see you in the next video.